Guys, welcome in Core Java interview question and answer. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about one of the very important Java interview question. And question is here, what is difference between intrinsic synchronization and explicit locking using lock? So as you know, if you want to achieve internal thread communication kind of scenario in Java, like you have a producer consumer problem, right? How do you resolve? Using you can implement producer consumer problem using either intrinsic synchronization or explicit locking using lock as well as condition interfaces, right? So here we will see the difference between intrinsic lock when you use synchronize keyword, or if you want to implement achieve synchronization using lock and condition interfaces. We'll see all the differences here. So let's go ahead. So here you can see I have designed a table. Left side you have an intrinsic synchronization, means when you use synchronize keyword, and another side, right side, you have an explicit locking using lock and condition interface. Let's see all the differences. So first difference is, in intrinsic synchronization case, it is not possible to interrupt a thread waiting to acquire a lock or attempt to acquire a lock without being willing to wait for it forever. So acquiring the lock in case of intrinsic synchronization, that up to depends on the JVM itself. You cannot go and interfere, right? You cannot do something in your code, right? That is up to the JVM when basically any thread is going to acquire the lock. But in case of explicit locking, right, you can provide option for timed, polled or interruptible locks, helping to avoid problematic deadlock. Yeah, so as you know, in Java we have a lock interface and corresponding implementation in reentrant lock, right? You can look for further more details, basically reentrant lock, right? Now next difference is, in case of intrinsic synchronization, responsibility of releasing a lock is handled by JVM even in case of exception occurs, right? So here when you use a simple synchronize keyword, then this is a responsibility of JVM to release the lock even in case of exception occurs, right? When you use explicit locking mechanism, then lock has to be released manually in the finally block once we have modified the protected or basically critical section. Yeah, so acquiring the lock, you can acquire the lock by calling the lock method, and we'll have to unlock the lock or release the lock in the finally block, right? So in case of explicit locking. Then third difference, when multiple locks are acquired, they must be released in the same order, and all locks must be released in the same lexical scope in which they were acquired. So when you use explicit synchronization and your thread is gonna acquire multiple locks, right, then in same order you will have to release the lock, right? And releasing a lock should happen in the same lexical scope, means same block, right? That's the case of intrinsic synchronization. But when we take an example of explicit locking, then explicit locking has ability to implement non-blocked structured locking. Lock does not have to be released in the same block of code, unlike synchronized locks, right? When you implement explicit locking, then in one block you can acquire the lock and another block you can release the lock. That's the facility you have in the explicit locking. Yeah, now when we take another difference in case of intrinsic synchronization, choice of fairness to the lock acquisition is not supported by intrinsic synchronization, right? When we take an example of explicit locking, then this offers choice of fairness to lock acquisition when multiple threads try to acquire the shared lock, setting fairness flag to true. So when you create an instance of reentrant lock, right, that's the implementation of lock interface, then reentrant, while creating an object itself, that constructor basically accept a fairness flag. So there you can specify the flag as true. So this will basically maintains the fairness to the lock acquisition, right? So that will give the chance to every thread to acquire the lock in a fairness manner. Yeah? Now, last but not on the list, when we talk about the intrinsic synchronization or synchronized keyword, right? So that is available from the initial version of Java itself. But when we talk about the lock interface, lock and condition interface, through which we get the explicit locking mechanism, so that is available from the JDK 1.5 onwards, right? So that's all I have in this video tutorial, guys. Guys, big thank you for watching this video. And if you did not subscribe KK Java Tutorials YouTube channel till yet, then please do subscribe. And if you want to learn Java in much more detail, then you can refer our website kkjavatutorials.com. Guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you there in the next video tutorial.